My name is Bella Jackman, and I am entering my third year at Colorado State University studying civil engineering and minoring in math. Today I'll be presenting about removing plastic straws from Camp Lindo High School, an environmental movement. This picture on the lower left is probably one that you've already seen. It's from a viral video of a sea turtle with a plastic straw lodged in its nostril. To introduce the problem, single-use plastics are dangerous to marine life. As you can see in the picture on the right of the Pacific Island garbage patch, plastics are an issue in marine life. To illustrate the problem of plastic straws, think about the circumference of the Earth, then imagine one long straw wrapping around the Earth 2.5 times. This straw is representative of the daily consumption of plastic straws in the U.S. alone. The setting is Camp Lindo High School in Moraga, California, which is where we are today. To preview the following main ideas, I will talk about why this is important, my personal goal, and possible solutions to the issues of plastic straws. So why is this important? Plastic straws are obviously an issue in the ocean, as seen in the last slide of the Pacific Island garbage patch. Plastic does not biodegrade, meaning it doesn't decompose, but instead breaks down and apart into smaller and smaller pieces, becoming microplastics, which is seen in the picture on the upper left. Microplastics weaken phytoplankton, which are the bacteria that make up the foundation of the food chain, causing reproductive health issues in the phytoplankton. Small fish and crustaceans eat the phytoplankton, but they don't get enough nutrients because they fill up on microplastics instead. So as the food chain grows, the microplastics bioaccumulate as the predator eat its prey. So large animals like whales, dolphins, and us essentially, humans, who eat mass amounts of small fish, bioaccumulate the microplastics. So why did I pick straws? The idea is to start small and give yourself a realistic goal that is reachable. So my ultimate goal is to educate the students and faculty of Camp Lindo High School and spread awareness through my plan of action, which is to contact the principal so he understands my plan of action, determine how many straws are used during a given lunch period, I will then set up posters, make announcements, and probably do a poetry slam and survey students during lunch. Then I will determine the number of straws used during lunch after the educational outreach study. I will then debrief the study with the principal to discuss the feasibility of eliminating plastic straws. If this plan of action is followed thoroughly, we will then reach possible solutions. These possible outcomes is that Camp Lindo will become a strawless school, and over time, paper straws will replace plastic straws, just how McDonald's has done in the UK and Ireland. Also, students and faculty will gain and spread awareness to families so they use less plastic straws and other single-use plastic outside of school. The best possible outcome is that other high schools in the district will avert from providing plastic straws in their cafeteria. This is the best solution because last year, students and faculty worked with Contra Costa County Central Sanitation District to add compost and recycling bins. Which this idea came about after Miramani is a high school in the district. They used a similar plan of action led by their environmental club. So to wrap it up, the possible benefits that will come from following my plan of action on reducing plastic straws in Camp Lindo will be that students and faculty will become educated and they will decrease their total consumption of single-use plastic. This action will spread in the school district just how Miramonte led by example and Campo followed to install compost and recycling bins on the school. Eventually, there will be a decrease in plastics ending up in marine environments, thus improving marine ecosystems. So to recap this presentation, I discussed why this is important, my personal goal of educating the students and faculty, and also the possible outcomes. This is a small step to the solution of obliterating casual use of straws and frivolous single-use plastics. The feasibility to get rid of all single-use plastics is less likely solved in one step, but rather over time as a movement led by people to stop distributing single-use plastics. Lastly, everyone has a part to play and there are no small steps. Thank you very much for your time.